All right, everyone, welcome to Simulink for Chemies. This first screencast will just help us get the lay of the land when we're using the Simulink software. The first thing to do is open the program. If you're watching this at Lafayette, click on the CHE software folder and double-click on the MATLAB icon. The command window should come up. Simulink is a powerful tool which allows you to model and analyze dynamic systems just by moving boxes around and connecting arrows. You can see how changes in one or more parameters can affect the system without having to go through all of the complicated pen and paper mathematics. It has a graphical user interface which makes everything easier to see, and you don't actually need to know how to code in MATLAB in order to use it. So we'll open up a new Simulink model. In the command window, click on New, and then scroll down and click on Simulink Model. Click the icon with the four colored squares to access the Simulink library. This can be found either on the main command screen, right here, or in the menus on the Simulink model screen. Simulink is used for many different dynamic systems not related to process control, so there are over 200 blocks to choose from. Therefore, the aspects of interest for this course are spread out all over the place. Most of the blocks that we're going to be using for process control problems are housed in the continuous section. These include transfer functions, PID controllers, and transport delays, which are used to add dead time to your model. Sources houses a whole host of forcing functions, including steps, ramps, and sinusoidal waves. These are used to create disturbances and set point changes in your process model. The signal routing subsection houses the MUX block. The MUX block is often used to combine the signals that come from different places, which will be useful in doing such things as plotting both the input and the output function simultaneously. Syncs contains the scope function, which enables you to see plots of your functions. Finally, if you go into math operations, you can find things like add blocks, subtract blocks, and scalar gain multipliers. Now the question that we're going to try and solve using Simulink is, how does the first order transfer function 6 over 4s plus 1 respond to a step input of 2? First, we have to put all the right blocks down on the drawing board. The first rule of Simulink is that all signals must start at a source and end at a sink. So when solving this problem, the source is a step input block. And the sink is a scope block. And we want to see how a particular transfer function is affected by the step, so we can go into continuous and grab a transfer function here. We're also going to need a MUX block from signal routing, so that way we can read multiple signals on the scope at the same time. So I think that's everything that we'll need. We can maximize this and lay everything out. So even though the blocks are on the drawing board, nothing is being modeled yet. Signals have to be sent from one place to another, and this is done by drawing arrows between all of the blocks. To add an arrow, just click and drag from the output of one block to the input of another block. So we have an arrow going from the MUX to the scope, we have an arrow going from the transfer function, and then we have an arrow going for the step. And we can edit the transfer function by double-clicking on it. In Simulink, transfer functions have to be typed in based on their coefficients. So to model 6 over 4s plus 1, we'll type 6 into the numerator, and then 4 space 1 into the denominator. The one's already there. We'll apply that, and it changes. And then we'll double click on the step change, and it's going to be at a step time of 0, at an initial value of 0, and a final value of 2, because we're dealing with a step change of 2. And we're reading the output signal from the process block, but it would also be helpful to read the input signal of the step function, because currently that's not being read. So we're going to take this extra port on the MUX and connect it to the input signal. And you can drag the arrows around too and move them in order to make your diagram look cleaner if you so choose. And then we can set the simulation time to 40 minutes. save our progress. We'll save this as first order. And then we can press run. And in order to see what happened, we have to double click on the scope block. And we'll go to auto scale. And there we go. Here's our step change in input. It goes from 0 to 2. And because the gain of our process transfer function is 6, the change in input is 2. So that means that the change in output is going to be 6 times 2, or 12. Also, the step input is instantaneous, but the process output is not instantaneous. It's got a very strong time dependence. And it will reach its final steady state value of 12 after roughly 5 times the time constant, which is 4. So after 20 minutes, you can see that it is nearly at its final steady state value. If you want to learn more about using Simulink to solve process control problems, you can watch my other videos and subscribe to the Lafayette CHBE YouTube playlist.